Zomato's CEO Depinder Goyal says that Zepto is burning over 2,500 crore rupees every quarter. But Zepto's CEO Adit Palicha calls this claim verifiably untrue. So who's right here? Welcome to our weekly Indian startup news show here at Backstage with Millionaires. I'm Caleb Friesen, your host, and we're diving into Zepto's numbers here to see if Depinder's claims hold up. So in FY24, Zepto's revenue grew by 120%, reaching 4,454 crore rupees. But surprisingly, despite their rapid expansion, their losses did not increase. At the time, Zepto had around 550 dark stores, but now they're on track to hit 1,200 by the end of this month. And Adit says that these dark stores only cost about 5-8% of Zepto's revenue to run and become profitable in under 18 months. And that could explain why their losses stayed in check despite their rapid growth. But of course, dark stores aren't the only place that Zepto is spending money. Zepto Cafe, their 10-minute food delivery service, is now doing 1 lakh orders per day. That's 30 lakh orders a month. And to scale this fast, Zepto has been offering heavy discounts, sometimes over 50% according to customer posts on X. So let's do some quick math here. Zepto Cafe's annualized GMV is around $100 million. That's roughly 850 crore rupees, with an average order value of 230 rupees and a 50% burn on discounts. Let's just apply that to all orders. Zepto is losing about 230 rupees per order in this hypothetical scenario. Multiply that by 1 lakh orders per day, and Zepto would be burning around 840 crore rupees per year, or roughly 210 crore rupees per quarter, which is a huge number, but it's nowhere near the 2,500 crore rupees that Depinder Goyal was mentioning. So, were Depinder's claims an exaggeration, or does Zomato know something that we don't? I guess we'll just have to wait and see. All right, next up in the news, Muks Robotics has launched Spaceo, their first humanoid on wheels designed and built entirely in India, right from its hardware to the operating system that powers it. And this isn't just a concept. Spaceo can lift 10 kilograms with its arms and carry 200 kilograms on its trolley. And Muks Robotics founder and CEO Mukesh Bangar told us that they developed their own vision language action model. It's a technique that allows them to train their robots with far fewer data sets compared to their competitors. And speaking of competition here, Tesla's humanoid Optimus is expected to cost between $20,000 and $30,000, but Muks Robotics has launched two variants of Spaceo, the M1 and the Pro. And while the Spaceo M1, which is designed for social settings like working as a butler, cost just $11,000, Spaceo Pro, their industrial grade version, which can be used in manufacturing and warehouses, is priced at $35,000. So why does Spaceo have wheels instead of legs? Well, Mukesh says that it's more practical, allowing for higher payload capacity, faster movement, better stability, and lower battery consumption. But Muks Robotics is also working on another version of Spaceo, which will have legs and is designed specifically for missions on Mars. And here's what makes this even more impressive. Muks Robotics has done all of this while staying bootstrapped. Just a year ago, they were testing software on an imported robot dog, but now they've built an entire humanoid from scratch. And they've proven their ability to make humanoids, and they're in the middle of raising their Series A round 2 to scale their operations. All right, next up in the news, Bhavesh Agarwal's AI venture Krutrim has just announced a partnership with Lenovo to build India's largest supercomputer. And according to the company, this supercomputer will be powered entirely by Krutrim's own cloud infrastructure. But that's not all, because while speaking at Lenovo's Tech World India event, Ola's group CIO, Navendu Agarwal, also announced their next big AI project, which is Krutrim 3. This AI model will be trained on 700 billion parameters, and to put that into perspective, their previous model, Krutrim 2, had just 12 billion. So this is all part of Ola's larger vision, to build India's largest AI infrastructure with everything from custom chips to its own cloud ecosystem. But Bhavesh Agarwal isn't just talking. He's already invested 2,000 crore rupees into Krutrim. Right now, 700 employees are working on Krutrim's full stack AI project. But while Krutrim is scaling up, it looks like Ola Electric is scaling down. They're laying off around 1,000 employees. Now, Ola Electric hasn't confirmed the exact number here, but they've acknowledged that a restructuring process is underway. Now, moving on to the next piece of news here, but continuing to talk about EVs, Indian EV maker Ultraviolette, known for their electric superbike, the F77, has expanded into the electric scooter segment with the launch of Tesseract. This electric scooter is priced at 1.45 lakh rupees, but the company is offering it at add 1.2 lakh rupees to their first 10,000 buyers. Now, talking about its specs, it offers a 261 kilometer range on a single charge and can hit a top speed of 125 kilometers per hour. It comes with three battery pack options, a 3.5 kilowatt hour, 5 kilowatt hour, and 6 kilowatt hour battery, and it can charge from 0 to 80% in just 1 hour. But that's not all, because Ultraviolette has also launched Shockwave, an electric motorcycle designed for everyday riders in India. It's priced at 1.75 lakh rupees, and Shockwave offers a 165 kilometer range and a top speed of 120 kilometers per hour. And if you're among the first 1,000 buyers, you can get it at a special price of 1.5 lakh rupees. And also, they're making both the Tesseract and Shockwave available for pre-bookings at 1,000 rupees on Ultraviolette's website. All right, next up in the news, and moving back to AI here, Zoho wants to launch two foundational models this year in 2025. But instead of building massive AI models, Zoho is going for efficiency. Their goal is to build smaller, smarter AI models that deliver higher accuracy with lower computational power. And just as a little bit of comparison, a little bit of context here, ChatGPT-4 has 175 billion parameters, and future models like ChatGPT-5 would hit 1.5 trillion probably. And so Zoho is sticking to a right-sized approach. They're building two foundational models, one with 7 billion parameters and the other with 13 billion parameters. Zoho wants to launch these models for Indian languages, but they have a huge challenge because Indian languages are complex, often blending English words and phrases, making training data tricky. But Zoho is taking inspiration from China's DeepSeek, focusing on smaller, more efficient AI instead of chasing scale like OpenAI or Krutrim. For now, Zoho is incorporating these models into their own products, but they'll roll them out publicly over the next 2 quarters. And Zoho's CEO, Shailesh Devi, is calling these models technology demonstrators. It's a way for them to prove that AI doesn't have to be massive to be powerful. All right, now let's move to the funding news segment for today's video. This week, Indian startups raised a total of $335 million. This is significantly higher than last week's $100 million. It's also way above the trend line. So let's take a look at some of the companies that raised funds this week. The first company I want to talk about here is DarwinBox. They offer an all-in-one HR software that companies can use to handle everything related to employees, from hiring, attendance, payroll, performance reviews, and even employee engagement. And they've raised $140 million. Following that, we have Gurugram-based consumer electronics brand Nook. They design and sell home and kitchen appliances like rechargeable table fans, mood lighting, vacuum cleaners, and blenders, and they've raised $5 million in their Series A round. After that, we have Bengaluru-based FluxGen, a company that provides IoT-based smart water management solutions used by businesses to monitor and optimize their water usage in real time. They've raised 28 crore rupees. That's about $3.22 million in their pre-Series A round. Next, we have Pune-based fintech startup Decimal. It's a micro-investing company that takes your spare change and invests it into mutual funds. So let's say you bought a book on Amazon for 295 rupees. So Decimal will round this up to 300 and invest the remaining 5 rupees into a mutual fund of your choice. And they raised $3 million in their seed round. And then finally, we have a Bengaluru-based fertility clinic, Arva Health, and they offer personalized reproductive health services like at-home fertility testing and IVF to individuals and couples. And they've raised $1 million in their pre-seed round. All right, that is all the Indian startup news that I have for you all this week. I really hope that you enjoyed the video. I'm Caleb Friesen, and this has been Backstage with Millionaires. But before I just wrap up, I wanted to say one thing. Last week was our 250th episode of this news series. And so I asked people to write in and just let me know how long they've been watching the show for. And I didn't really think that there would be that many comments, but there were so many comments that I haven't even gotten a chance to reply to them all. But it was really meaningful for me because normally we upload these videos and we get a couple of comments here and there, which is perfectly fine. You see the number of viewers, 10,000, 20,000, something in that range. But actually seeing so many comments from people saying, oh, I've been watching the show for 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, sometimes more than that. And people saying, I tune in every single week. This is a staple for me. I can't live without this show. I mean, that really touched me. It was really meaningful for me. And I just wanted to let you all know that. And I wanted to let you all know that I appreciate you tuning in and watching these videos that we make every single week. So thank you so much. And I will catch you in the next one.